Okay, let's go ahead and look at some percentage change. Let's use the formula. We have new minus the old, and if you don't like the term old, you can say original, over divided by the old times 100. So I'm going to, the new is 41 nails minus the original, which is 36, over the old or the original, which is 36. And if you take 41 minus 36, that equals 5. And then 5 over 36, if you divide 5 by 36, that equals 0.14. And you multiply that by 100, and that equals 14%. And since it is positive and you went from 36 to 41, it will be a percentage increase. Okay? Now let's flip to the other side and let's look at one that is a decrease. So why don't we go here? We have a wooden toy. The original price is $14.99. Now it is $11.18. So the new price is 11.18. Minus the old or the original, whichever term you like best, over the old term, which is $14.99. Now, in this particular instance, when you subtract 11.18 minus 14.99, you get a negative 3.81. So that tells you it's going to be a percent decrease. And you put 14.99 because that is the old price or the original price. When you divide 3.81 by 14.99, you get 0.25, negative 0.25, and multiply that by 100, and that is a negative 25%. So you're going to get a percent decrease of 25%. Okay, so that's how we work a negative. And let's go ahead and go with one more example. We'll move to number two here. And you started with 15 taxis and now you have 5. So I'm going to go new minus old over old. 5 minus 15, the difference is a negative 10 over 15, and 10 divided by 15 is equal to a negative 0.67 times 100 equals negative 67%. So it will be a percent decrease. Okay, hope that helps. Again, the formula is you take new minus old over old times 100, and that will give you the percent increase or percent decrease. Thanks for watching MooMooMath.